Hey, welcome back to Extreme Angler. This week from Foliette, west of Timmins, on beautiful Horwood Lake, out of this place right here, White Moose Wilderness Outpost. They say outpost and you think maybe really rustic and stuff. This place has got it all, man. Washrooms inside, fantastic dock sections and stuff. And will you check this out? We're on this lake here. The way they designed this place for these docks to be safe, it's incredible. Take some ingenuity and think about the anglers plugging in their boats and things, and they're safe regardless of the conditions on the lake. I'm gonna fish with my good buddy, Connor Dunn, whether for walleyes, maybe smallmouth, some pike, but just have some fun at this outpost camp.
Okay, so the first night we got here, we went out and bottom bounced some structure off some islands and found a ton of walleyes. Once we found them, we vertical jigged with 3/8 ounce jigs and just put a smacking on them. Nothing big, but beautiful eaters.
Connor, this is the way you find a lot of walleyes, huh?
Yes, sir. Cover water, live bait rigs.
Cover water and find walleyes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. We're going to start about how deep?
I'm thinking around 19.
Okay.
And then work our way out.
Okay. Oh, not that time.
Got him.
Oh, no.
Double.
Get the bait around.
Double.
Uh-oh. Listen to that braid. Wow. Yeah. Eaters?
Yes, sir.
On a first pass.
First pass.
How big is that?
Mine's not bad here.
Is it? You need that on yours?
I don't know. I'll use a net.
I just got a
little eater.
Look at that. Hey, how's yours feel? Want me to get the net?
I don't know. He might be able to lift. He's a net.
Is he?
A keeper.
Okay.
But I'll flip him in.
All right. But that's how we started.
There we go.
Pretty impressive, eh?
Double header, first pass.
What a rig. Deadly, dude. Deadly. I felt a couple bouncing off the bottom and just right away, eater. Like, this one's a little too small.
A little small, yeah. Okay. That's a little small.
Bye-bye. And just enjoy myself the same way you will when you come to places like this in Northern Ontario. And we're on Algoma District. It's actually called Algoma Country. And they have everything you want for a fantastic fishing vacation. Your family, friends, your buddy trips. This is the kind of place you want to go to. The fishing is phenomenal in Horwood Lake. Okay, we get to the camp, unload our stuff. Me and Connor are excited as little kids, you know, want to get out and go fishing and stuff. So he says, what do you want to do? Some bass, some pike, walleye? It's walleye. And how? He's got bottom bouncers and ball head jigs. Off we go.
First night we go out, bottom bounce for a bit, find the fish, drop down, double header right off the bat.
Like that. And it's a better fish.
Look at that, better fish.
Yeah, man.
Double header, a good one,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, man. That's the deal, Connor. Hey?
There we go.
Just put it down. Wow. Dude.
There we go.
You got to admit, man, that is fun. So that tells me that maybe those big guys didn't want to chase
it. They didn't want to chase.
Hey?
They don't want to chase it. Yeah.
Wow, look how hot they are, too. Look how golden those fish are.
Look at that.
Hey, that's eater.
Those are eaters.
These are both eaters.
Those are eaters.
Eaters. In the box they go, boys.
See, I told you I wasn't lying. This lake is full of fish.
Pretty good choice, eh? That's what happens when you're with a good guide. Connor Dunn fished with him years ago. He says, bottom bouncing. And then when we find the clusters, pick up the old ball head jigs and have fun. That's what happens at the White Moose Wilderness Outpost. First night, let's go catch some more. The walleyes are almost everywhere. Connor's got a different perspective on how we're going to fish. I like ball head jigs. He's got bottom bouncers. We're going to be trolling some Missouri cranks. So there's variety involved in a great little vacation up here in a fantastic wilderness setting from the White Moose. A little bit of shaking. These fish are just sick, dude. There's a good one again. Wow.
Really? Oh, nice. You need net?
No, I think it's just like.
Oh, he's a good one.
Hey?
Nice, that's a good one.
Wow, like a little kid, man. Holy moly. Wow, dude. I hit the bottom and all I just
right
lifted
away.
Up, there was nothing. I didn't do one jig, Connor, not one jig. Not one jig. Look at those leeches. Wow, that's a sharp hook from that Josh McKay guy. Northern Tackle Supply, good hooks. For walleye, that's what they look like.
In the box.
Right here, man. And he is going in the box.
So
So I told Karl about a lodge that I know of up here at Horwood Lake, run by a partner, Scott Millions. And Karl got a hold of Scott. Scott hooked us up. Beautiful trip.
There's a better fish right there.
Is it? Netter?
He's probably not bad. He's putting a little bit of bend in there. I'll probably scoop him, Connor.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, nice and orange he is. There's a beauty. Nice eater fish.
Yeah, man. Isn't that nice? Look at that nice jig head just sticking in his mouth. Just a gorgeous little fish, man. Gorgeous. Nice eaters. But we already had our fish fry. Ow, you got me with his gill raker. Oh, yes. Oh, he got me again. Oh, nice one. Worm's still working. Connor says, lots down there. They're just taking their time. It's a traditional after dinner bite. Can't beat it, Northern Ontario lodges. This is the deal right here. This is what people come for right here. That after evening bite, catching some walleye. As for colors and stuff, you know me, you know what? Pinks, green with chartreuse. And on this trip, I don't know what the walleyes wanted, man, but almost every other drop when Connor put me right on top of those fish, orange with chartreuse. And that is thanks to my buddy at Northern Tackle Supply, Josh. Thank you, Josh. You were right. Northern lodges in Ontario, they love the chartreuse and orange. There he is. Yeah, and that's not bad.
Not bad.
Whoa. Better. Oh, look at that. Whoa. Unless he's hit the way he's not supposed to. Oh, it's a good one.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. Look at him. Hey. He's a nice one. Yeah.
On the leech.
On the leech.
Yep. I just put that down there, Connor, with the leech.
Beautiful.
I'm going to take him out. I'm going to put that in there, Connor. Could you just grab that? Whoa. Walleye. We had our shore lunch, had our shore fish. She has to go back. Ready, boy? That's a nice fish, too. Nice chunker. Ready? Go on. Bye. Thank you.
When you come up to White Moose Wilderness Outpost, you're allowed 4 fish. You can have 1 fish over 18 and 3 fish under, or you can have all your 4 fish under 18 inches. Karl and I had a fantastic fish fry. We kept 6 fish, which was plenty for us. It was delicious.
Oh, he's nice.
Is he?
Yeah.
Like net nice?
I don't know. He's a lot bigger than he on the other little
That's
guy.
A decent fish.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, man.
Yeah. See how he's not as orange as the other ones?
Mm-hmm. Eaters if we needed them.
Eaters if we did need them.
Okay, let's keep trying it. Get down there. Yeah, I hit it really good, like da-doom. And I gave him an extra second to do the inhale, and he had it pretty good. Maybe that squirmy leech, man, just inspired that fish. I was looking at it, Connor, you know?
Well, you catch one more, you know what happens.
I know. Connor changes to the leech again, too. There's a fish. Ready? Ready?
Give it to him. Oh!
You're right there. No, he's like the little guys I've been catching. Oh, yeah. Just a colorful little walleye. He spit the lucky leech, dude. Yep. But look where that is. Hey, look where that is. Right through past the lip. That fish was never coming off. Never coming off. You just wish them bigger ones could hook like that.
Mm-hmm.
Just making some evening magic right there. Having some fun. Bye. You gotta admit it, man. I got the best job on earth. Get to hook up to some fantastic Northern Ontario lodges, outpost camps, great guys like Connor, and just meet like the owners and see that they really put in that effort to make sure that your vacation, your trips are as memorable as they're going to be. So think about it with your buddies, your wife, you know, a bachelor party, who cares what it is. Get out with your buddies to a place like this. You can relax, let loose, catch walleye, smallmouth, pike, and really make memories that are going to last a lifetime. There we go. Unless I snagged it, it's a better fish.
Yeah, eh?
Oh yeah, look. Unless it's snagged.
Don't be snagged. Oh yeah.
No,
Karl.
He's a little bit better.
Oh yeah,
eh?
There we go.
A little bit chunky, huh?
A little bit chunkier. There you go.
But I got him underneath, look at that.
Yeah.
Hey, he went to eat the leech. Look what happens. The jig finds the bottom. That's what sharp hooks do. Very important. Northern Tackle Supply. buddy Josh, thank you for making these jigs, dude. The walleyes, cannot resist them. And I can hook fish even when they don't want to eat the bait. Just a little chunker. Whoop. Northern Ontario gold bar. Ready? Smell like the walleyes we've eaten.
Mm-hmm.
Go on, boy. See ya. See ya for another night. Okay, so bottom bouncing, I haven't done it in a long time. You know, dragging little blades with beads and stuff and split shots, that's my forte. But Connor, he just knows how to find walleyes, man. One little island and stuff, first pass, bang. We're getting some small unders and stuff, but it doesn't matter. I'm fishing, new place, and we're just finding walleyes and we're having fun like two little boys going fishing for the first time.
I want to show you what we're doing today on Horwood Lake out of White Moose Wilderness Outpost. We're using bottom bouncers. We're trolling them just close to structure, rock piles. And we're using worms and leeches. Today I'm using a worm. You use about an inch and a half of a night crawler. And this is called a slow death hook. It's got a bend to it. See like that? You take the hook and you throw it right through the tip of the worm. You thread it through all the way until you see the collar of the worm. Go through the collar of the worm, out. And then when you tie your hook on, there's always going to be a tag end. You push the worm past the tag end and it keeps it there from sliding back down. Now, this will make a rolling action in the water, okay? And if you can see, maybe you can see this. You can see it spin. There's a saying, if you ain't spinning, you ain't winning. So that's what we do with this setup. We're using a 1.5 ounce to 2 ounce bottom bouncer. And yeah, I like to show you what kind of fish you can catch with this type of setup here at Horwood Lake. We've been doing phenomenal the last day and a half. Lots of nice fish. Here's a nice 21 incher that we just caught, put in the live well. Get some air. Look at that. Now when you're releasing these big fish, you gotta take your time. Don't just throw it in and let it go. Let it get some air. There you go, just like that.
All right, so Connor says, you know, one thing good about Horwood Lake, there's so many different ways to catch walleye. From when the season opens all the way up to almost freeze up. But he says one of his most favorite ways is trolling big deep diving cranks like the Yuzuri crank. So if I have an opportunity to find some different kind of walleyes, maybe some big walleyes with the crankbait, hey man, I'm in. Variety is the spice of life.
There we go.
Fish?
Yeah.
Feel them?
Yeah.
All right, let me bring this one in.
Yeah.
Yeah? Bring my rod in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or just, you can leave it out.
Okay. So they're showing you they want to go this way, Connor, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, it's another one of those little eaters, eh?
Yeah.
You can just lift him in. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Yep. The eater type. That's eater type. But he proved it. He did say maybe one way is better than the other way. One's setting up and one on the board, so maybe we're on to something.
Better one.
Bye.
So today we went and trolled some rock faces off of this arm on Horwood Lake. It's one of my favorite ways to catch big walleyes. We caught some nice fish, but remember, please release the big fish. Take your time.
Yep.
Don't pump it.
Just nope.
Keep it solid.
Well, we're drifting, that's why.
Okay. No, I got a spot lock. The boat's just going to turn around. So you can go to whatever side you want.
I think I still got him.
Yeah, I'm out.
I'm right here, right behind the boat.
Yeah, take your time though, I'm not in, and then I get the net for you. There we go.
Hook came out.
Hook come out.
Hook come out. He buried it too, dude.
Yeah.
Just another good eater, eh?
You know. While we were trolling up this arm, we used planer boards with deep diving crankbaits. And we started off the morning fishing both lures off the same side of the boat just to increase our chances because the fish were pushed in tight. As the day moved on, the fish moved out. We put two planer boards out, covered some water. It was a great morning.
Nope, he is there. On. Yeah.
Right on. I'll just keep going unless you feel weight.
He's just one of those eaters again. He's just one of those eaters.
So right in this gap, eh?
Yeah, man. Well, the good thing is he's staying down a little bit, right?
Oh, yeah?
Like, I mean, he's not on the surface.
Yeah.
Surfing him in.
Yeah.
Whoa.
You might, did he come awake here?
No, he's good. He's just...
Oh, you want to come on? There we go. Nice walleye.
Yeah.
Nice walleye. There we go.
There we go. Another one of those ones that are good for the fryer, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. He buried it.
He did.
Like there was no hesitation, dude. On that Yuzuri, eh?
Yeah.
Look at the color of those fish. I'm sure you're gonna be inspired when you see me having the kind of time that you could have right here by picking up the phone, get on the internet, give them a call, and you come on up, enjoy Northern Ontario like the way everybody else does, especially yours truly. So let's get our stuff, put it in the boat, go out and see what kind of fish are waiting for us in a late afternoon, early evening from the outpost camp. Let's go do it. Horwood Lake is famous for its walleye fishing, but the smallmouth bass are starting to make a name for themselves. So we have to take advantage of some evening topwater to end our trip.
That's got to be a smallmouth, unless it's a pike. It's going to go underneath you.
Here, come on this side, I'll spot lock it.
Ooh.
It's a pike or a bass.
No, it's a bass.
Is it a bass?
Yeah, we should just probably...
Oh, yeah.
Let's stay probably right here.
Want me to net it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's a nice one.
You got him. Attaboy. Yeah. Good stuff. You got sharp hooks on that thing?
Mm-hmm.
That's how they look, too. Hey, put a few in there just for me for some pictures?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's put them in there for some pictures. Smallmouth, too. White moose. Look how chunky they are. Look at the bellies on those fish. You know, they're just gorging, probably in the crayfish in here. We'll stay back, throw the Yuzuri prop bait. Have some fun. Let's do it. Well, another outdoor adventure that I'll never forget for the rest of my days. And I'm so grateful that these opportunities that I have to see the things that you only see on TV. All you got to do is pick up the phone, get on the internet, call these lodges and experience the same things you see this guy doing, making memories forever with crankbaits, jigs, walleyes, and good friends.
Oh, see? Oh, nice. That was a nice shot. Oh, beauty.
I'll bring him around this side.
On your side?
Yep. Oh, maybe not.
That was nice.
I'll let him dance a bit for him. I'm gonna just lift them in here. Three, two, one. Nope. We'll get bigger.
Yeah?
Oh yeah, I'm confident, man. I'm with Connor Dunn.
Yeah, hey.
Okay? Let's put him back. Yeah. Nice river, smallmouth. See how they fight? Wow. Okay, boy. Ready? Go on.
I'd like to thank Karl for this opportunity to come out this weekend. Fantastic. It was nice to catch up again and spend some time in the water with a good friend. Hope we can do it again. It was nice to also catch up with a good friend of mine, Scott Millions, out at White Moose Wilderness Outpost. Please come out and check it out. Beautiful spot.
Well, that's a wrap. Wow. Fish with my buddy, Connor Dunn, man. Some smallmouth, some walleye, some pike, and a whole lot of fun. From White Moose Wilderness Outpost up here, just west of Timmins in Folliette. Thanks for watching. Think about this place because they're here for you for the time of your life, like me, my buddy Connor. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler. Plan your next wilderness adventure with White Moose Wilderness Outposts by contacting them online at www.whitemooseoutpost.com or email at info@whitemooseoutpost.com.